Good evening and welcome to the St. Clair College Sportsplex, the site of the 2015 OCAA Men's Volleyball Championships, day one of action here on WE TV. Hello everybody, my name is Dominic Papa. Joining us is our volleyball analyst, Coach Dave Austin, Coach Chris Brecka, one that a lot of the local fans have been waiting for, is about to unfold here tonight. The St. Clair College Saints doing battle with the Durham Lords. The Lords come in, of course, winning the East Division, a perfect 18-0 record. These two teams have not played against each other during a regular season, but they did see each other earlier in a tournament, correct?
Yes,
they did.
The beginning of the season, they played in the Adidas Cup in Oshawa.
Okay, and St. Clair actually won that tournament.
And our boys won the tournament and beat Durham in that tournament 3 straight.
But obviously a lot changes, Dave.
Well, it does, and no disrespect to the Durham Lords, Dom, but in this playoff tournament, the West teams have been consistently beating the teams from the East, and hopefully as local fans, it's going to happen again tonight.
Yeah, we got a nice house filling in here at the Sportsplex. The Saints, by the way, are 12-6 on the regular season, but as Coach Austin just alluded to, the East Conference, the East Division, much different than the West. The West, a lot more depth, a lot more competitive, so we'll see how that all factors into this game here this evening. For the Saints, a huge loss during the week, though. They lose one of their main guys, Dave Binder, to an injury.
Has a fractured finger.
Okay.
So he won't be playing tonight.
Yeah, how much does that change the dynamics for Coach Lynch?
Well, you know, Dave is he's a powerhouse for them, and he's the guy that never says die, and he always keeps those balls in play. So, I think someone's got to step up and take that role.
But Coach Lynch has also been smart in using his bench frequently this year, too. And all that experience, as little as it may be, does pay off when kids get in a situation like this. So hopefully somebody will step in, do the job.
You two are very volleyball experienced, very volleyball tested, we'll say. Of course, St. Clair, the host team here. Does that add some pressure to them?
I think the pressure is understandable just being at this level. But being the home team, I think they're more excited than feeling the pressure. I think they're anxious to get out there and play.
And they've played well here all season, Dave.
They have, and there's great advantage to being familiar with your surroundings in the game of volleyball. You can judge in and out balls a lot better.
Just quickly, give Durham a shout-out. Let's take a look at some of the numbers, actually, first, if we can. Of course, total kills, Jason Hernandez, an all-star, 208. He's got to be big tonight.
He's the MVP of the league. At the awards banquet this morning, was named MVP. Mm-hmm. He's got to step up tonight and be the MVP.
All right, and then you look at total digs, and again, very decisive for the Saints here, Chris. All these numbers, very decisive.
Yes, it is. I mean, on paper, they're the team.
All right, and total blocks, you can see Travis Wagle leading the way there with 48. The Durham Lords, who's key for them? What's got to happen for them to be successful?
Well, I think our boys are aggressive servers, so they got to get that pass in there so that their setter can get the ball out to their hitters.
All right.
I'm an old setter. I think the game always revolves around the setter.
All right. You've been consistent all night with that,
I
too,
have.
That's for sure.
I have.
Good stuff. We'll be checking in with the two of you throughout the contest, and I'm excited about it. It's going to be a great game, and certainly we look forward to your expertise breakdown of all of this, okay? So that sets up the game for you. Now we're going to go over to our play-by-play team. Of course, that'll consist of Shane Burney and Steve Gomes as we get to the opening ceremonies of game number 4 of the OCAA Men's Volleyball Championships here on WE TV.
Welcome everybody, courtside here. I'm Steve Gomes, and to my left is Shane Burney. We'll be handling the festivities for you here today. And let's just take a look at the amazing opening ceremonies that we have here to preview the game for St. Clair College here, opening it up as the home host. We're going to let the public address announcer take it over here for a moment to introduce both teams. Now entering the visiting Durham Lords. Mm-hmm. And to welcome in the St. Clair Saints, we have the band performing none other than When the Saints Come Marching In. And on cue, here comes your St. Clair Saints.
Oh, I love the playoff atmosphere. This just adds to it.
Packed gym, home team entering in front of the mascot, cheerleaders to follow. Packed house.
Away.
This place is just gonna go bonkers. If you can't be here tonight, you sure are tuned into the right place. WeTV taking you through the entire weekend here for OCAA as we pause for the national anthem. No better way to honor our country than to pause before an athletic event. Great job by the entrance band and the performer of the national anthem honoring our country and this great and wonderful game that we play here. As the team shake hands, I'm sure there's not a lot of welcome wishes across the net.
Yeah, this is going to be a really exciting game. We have Durham on one side who played in the East. Which is assumed to be a little bit of an easier division, but they're 18-0, so they've kind of rolled through the entire division against, you know, St. Clair, a little more battle tested, 12-6 on the year, but they've had some tough matches and they've, had those character building games that they either won or lost. So it'll be really interesting how Durham handles adversity after coming out of a undefeated season.
Well, if you just take a look around, you've got a packed house and you're on the road and you're the unbeaten team. It just doesn't seem fair.
No.
Yeah, you've got a capacity crowd building here and it's just going to be bonkers. Every point that St. Clair scores, the roof's going to pop off this place. How do you combat that as a coach? What are you telling your team if you're George?
Yeah, you really got to come off to a hot start. And I know that's easy to say, but it's hard to do. So you really got to rely on your veterans early in the game and, make it easy for those rookies and young players.
Right, and Durham has some experience to draw on in their coaching staff. You look at Dan Miller, he's a fifth year in the coaching program, but he's also played battle-tested games as a Western alumni playing in the OUA. Hopefully, they'll be able to pull on his experience as he was a very good, strong middle in the league for years.
And St. Clair is dealing with a big blow from practice earlier in the week. As you heard in the pregame, Dave Binder, he's got a broken, fractured hand. So that's a huge blow. He's been one of their outlets, one of their leaders, and a lot of experience there. So we'll see how they react.
And Jean-Marc Lepin gets things kicked off for the Saints. The Lords go outside, and that was Eric Jansen. He was dug. Right side attack from Petrus keepers point. Lords. Lords strike first blood.
Yeah, we'll see how Durham attacks the serving today. Mannix in the serving rotation. Usually that's Dave Binder, so we'll see if they key on him.
Right outside to OCAA Player of the Year, Hernandez for the Saints, as he's stuffed, not what we're used to seeing from him.
Yeah, big block by Petrus. So Jay's going to really have his hands full. But he should only have to deal with it when he's got this left side hitting rotation.
Rankin. Right side to Manic, and he puts it down. Point Saints.
Now Manic is Dave Binder's replacement today, and he's an explosive young player, so we'll see how he handles getting the spotlight here.
Manic Chandoria with the serve. Ball goes up the middle for the Lords. Matthew Gibson setting up the big middle, Nick Coleman.
And Durham likes to set middle, so they should have a steady attack today. It's going to be a big job for Peter Christian and Travis Weigel.
Manic with a good pass to Jean-Marc, and the kill out of the middle. Peter Christian, point, Saints. Serving Christian. Float serve. Up the middle, and nothing happening for the Lords. Roof put up by the Saints.
Yeah, he didn't fool Travis on that one. He was ready, and he had some help from Connor and Jay.
Triple block, Saints putting it to the test. Ball goes outside. And that's just ugly. Eric Jansen did not have his best swing. Saints on top, 4-3. Early on, first set of the feature matchup, Friday night, 8 p.m. start. Serve finds the net, knotted up at 4.
You know, it's exciting being a part of this atmosphere. You know, the crowd's loud. They've got some noisemakers out there or whatever they have, but you know, it's a cool atmosphere to be a part of right now.
How about the big face heads or fat heads they got going out there? Lepe goes right side to Hernandez, and there's a kill. I think he's had a few of those in his career, Hernandez.
Yeah, the OCAA second all-time leading point getter. So, you know, he's seen a few sets that he's liked in his past.
And now he's got a serve. Tough load serve. Outside for the Lords, Rankin with the dig. Lepang goes to the dump. There's the advantage of having a left-handed setter.
Now Lepang's been playing all year this year with Josh Lynch, has been rehabbing a knee, but he's really thrived given the opportunity. The team really enjoys playing with him and just good leader on the court.
And there's the answer, the return dump, Matthew Gibson. Now that's a 6'4" setter with 5 years of playing experience in the OCAA. That's
yeah, watching warm-ups, he didn't look like the setter. Sometimes you can see people warming up and you can pinpoint who it is. He's a big guy.
Big front court here for the Lords. Let's see what the Saints go to battle. They go Manic out of the back court, off the tape and down. Point for the Saints as they're up too early.
It's key for St. Clair to get Mannix started early. You know, young players, you never know how they're going to deal with adversity of a playoff game. So getting a few kills under his belt, you know, should open things up later on.
Connor West's serve could not be handled easily by the Lords. Lepang goes to West in the backcourt. Had to be a free ball. But how that finds a kill, must be some early nerves on the Durham side.
Yeah, you can see his head on the sideline celebrating as well as him for his volley kill.
You don't see too many of those. Connor West with the serve for the Saints. Terrible pass, one option left, and that's the back court for the Lords. And it's a success.
Good back row attack by Durham there.
Serving for the Lords is Matthew Gibson, the setter. all 6-4 of them. There, you can see they're going right after Manic. And a net call on the dump on Jean-Marc as he follows through into the net. Caught a bit of the tape.
Looks like Durham has a few playoff beards going across the roster. Some of them were capable of growing it, some weren't.
And some of them just don't look so good. And that's out of bounds, Point Saints. Looks like Josh Rankin and Travis Weigel look like the only starters for St. Clair sporting the nasty beards. Right side attack, dug up by West. Manic to answer. Right side attack, they try it again, and West comes up with the dig. Hernandez tattoos the backcourt defender, Matthew Gibson.
Just unloads. Really good approach. It jumped right before the attack line and just put absolutely everything into that one.
That's why he's number two all time. Durham goes up the middle. Number nine, Mike Harper, gets a kill. Serving, Jeremy Hoekstra, 6'3", in his fifth year out of Cobourg, Ontario. Looks like he's gonna spin one up here. No, goes with the jump float. Manic with a great pass, able to run all three options. Why not Hernandez? Again, goes backcourt for West, and the Saints come out gunning. Connor West, welcome.
Saints are going to the back row attack early and having a lot of success. You know, they've been working together all year, and you can tell there's really good chemistry between those guys.
Starts with a good pass, and the middle's drawing up all the blocks. A serve, Jean-Marc Le Pen. Forcing an early timeout by head coach John Matsusaki of the Durham Lords as they trail 8-12. You're watching OCAA Volleyball here on WE TV.
It's not just about hockey. It's about getting your great education too.
Academics are equally, if not more important than athletics. The Hockey Canada Skills Academy is a great opportunity for any student athlete to live their dream and chase their passion. It gives them an opportunity to get a workout in the morning, they're physically and mentally engaged, and it helps them as a student as well throughout the day. Our program is not just for the elite athletes, it's for everyone.
Hi, I'm Ed Jovanovsky. Watch us on WE TV. We got you covered.
And we're back here at the St. Clair College Athletic Center. What an atmosphere, what a start. Saints up 12-8 over the Durham Lords early, and we've got a rockin' house.
Yeah, St. Clair has played well with this rockin' crowd, so Durham calls the early timeout, maybe to settle them down or settle down their players. We'll see how they are able to handle this.
Jean-Marc Le Pen continues to serve, and he pumps an ace out of the timeout. What a swing by the 6'2 left-handed setter out of Maidstone, Ontario.
Ice in his veins. I love seeing a setter be aggressive on the serve, and especially after a timeout.
Goes right back to it and blows it out of bounds. That's the one you got to get in. Lords looking to cut into this momentum. Down four, first set. As you can hear the crowd just giving it to the server here, Mike Harper. Le Pen goes outside to Hernandez. Ball's kept alive. Gibson goes right side. And that's a hitting error brought to you by Petrus Cupers. And it looks like they're reversing the call, going with a touch. I didn't see it.
Yeah.
Not many other people did. Very interesting turn of events here.
Petrus has a huge size advantage against the St. Clair outside, so we'll see if that factors into this game.
Ball goes down for the Saints. That's a point courtesy of Peter Christian. Another experienced middle.
Yeah. He, I believe, played at Seneca with Jay Hernandez earlier in his career, so he's experienced before making his way over to St. Clair.
Manic with an ill-advised serve out of bounds. Like him being aggressive, but you still got to be close. Petrus keepers. Connor West with a dime pass, going right side to Hernandez, and I think there's a dent in the floor. Hernandez flexes the muscle.
Yeah, it all starts from that set. John Mark almost over the net, pulling that ball back to John Mark. Really good set that, you know, gave him lots of options. So
he's come a long way as a setter. Yeah. Big dig by Manic. Saints rallying. Setter gets up, LePe, athletic to Hernandez. And it looks like Paul Higgins, the up official, is gonna call the ball down. Point for the Lords.
Now you say Jean-Marc's come a long way. You got some inside into where he's been.
Well, I've had the pleasure of helping out coaching him at Essex High School. He's just a very gifted athlete. Anytime you can get somebody that's left-handed to set the ball, just a great asset to have. And Connor West just unleashes on a ball. Again, this is really a program that's pulled from all across the country here. Connor West from Lethbridge, Alberta, just been a great addition to this program here. He's in his third year. Outside, Hoekstra can't get it done. LePan goes right back to Hernandez and he finds the tape. Just looked a little late on that ball.
Yeah. Mix of being a little late, maybe the set was a little low. Maybe just try to keep that one in.
Here it is, Nick Coleman with the serve and it finds the net. Point Saints. Connor West with the serve. As the crowd gets pretty silent, anticipating the serve, and there it is. One option, the backcourt. Eric Jansen misses for the Lords. Way wide. And Coach George Matsusaki calls another timeout. He's got none left. What's he saying to his team here there, Mr. Bernie?
You know, it's still early, first set of the match. They're down five at this point, but you can tell that nerves is playing a big factor. I saw Nick Coleman come off the court after a missed serve, and you could just see it in his face that, you know, maybe the moment has got to him to start this. So you really need to kind of fight that off, get a couple points, get either a pass or a serve or something. And, you know, get yourself comfortable with what's going on.
Yeah, and it's pretty hard to get comfortable in this place. As you see, we've got the cheerleaders out here. We've got a packed crowd. It's hard to play in this kind of adversity. It's something you don't experience all the time.
You know, and some people thrive in this type of scenario, and some people wilt. And you really don't know until it happens. You know, you'll see different people in all sports that, you know, play better in the playoffs, play better in the big moment. So you just hope that you have some of those guys on your team.
And right now it looks like the Saints are benefiting from this wild crowd. We'll see how it goes after the timeout here.
Yeah, everything has gone the Saints' way so far in this match. Everything they've tried has worked well, and Connor's made a lot of key digs.
Connor West with the serve. Right side attack from the Lords goes long, and that's another attacking error by Petrus Keepers, or Keepers. Saints up six early in front of their home crowd. Friday night, marquee game. Connor West. Another awful pass by the Lords. Somehow they get it done. Jeremy Hoekstra, after the bad pass, give him a set, why not?
Yeah, made up for the bad pass.
Matthew Gibson, the setter, with the serve. Manick delivers a good pass, allows the middle set from LePain, and that's Travis Weigel, 6-4 out of the middle, getting her done. Weigel back to serve after the kill. You see that all the time, service error after a kill. Hardest time to get your serve in.
Yeah, for some reason, players just lose focus just for that split second after their big kill.
You gotta bring that adrenaline right down. Hoekstra goes for the float serve. They're serving Manick, and he's been doing a pretty good job until that point. And Jean-Marc LePain gets called for two hits. Saints still up 4, 20-16. Jeremy Hoekstra continues to serve for the Lords. And
he likes to fake the spin serve, but then go over to the jump float.
Manick, LePain, back to Manick. Off the block and down, point Lords. As you can see, some energy entering into that Lords team.
So Manick's had a role in the last 2 points. You know, it's, let's see how he rebounds. The guys are trying to rally him. Might see Josh Rankin take a little more court.
And now we have an overpass point for the Saints as Jean-Marc LePain gets the kill. That's the value of having a tall, left-handed athletic setter. And we got a substitution for the Lords here. Exiting the game is Jeremy Hoekstra. Entering the game is 14, Braden Rogers. Now he's a libero by trade, so they're clearly bringing him in for some defense and passing. As they're trailing by 4, 21-17. LePain bombs a serve. Outside attack handled by Josh Rankin. Connor West out of the backcourt finds the bottom of the net. Not what they were looking for.
You can feel the Durham gaining momentum as this set is progressing. Hopefully St. Clair can, you know, rally before this set ends.
Just fresh off the bench here, Luke Kilbourne serves it up for the Lords. All options available, why not go Hernandez? And uncharacteristic, ball goes out of bounds.
Yeah, Jay, almost to a fault, always goes full speed. So he'll catch a lot of breaks from hitting through blocks and using blocks, but occasionally he could benefit from taking some off.
No touch, ball goes out of bounds, but we have an overrule from up official Paul Higgins, and I think that's the right call. I don't know about you, but my initial instinct was the line judges had it wrong, and Paul Higgins steps up and makes the right call, puts the Saints up 3, 22-19.
Very pivotal call at this point in the game.
That's an experienced official, not afraid to make a call. Manick with the serve. Ooh. And some dirty fingers. Called on the Lords. You just can't touch it that many times.
Yeah, for those new to volleyball, anytime you see a lot of spin on the ball after coming out of the setter's hands, usually something went wrong.
Manick with the serve. Gibson pumps it in the middle, and there's a big kill for the Lords.
Yeah, good swing out of Gibson. He's undersized for the position, but he, you know, jumps well, and you can tell that he can hit some good angles.
Hey, poor setter's got to almost set the ball down to him. Keeper's serve handled by the Saints. Connor West goes off speed. Dug up by the Lords. They go outside. Jansen gets the kill. Wasn't pretty. Gets the job done. Substitution, Lords. We've got Ben Gledhill entering the game.
A lot of defensive substitutions going on right now for Durham. They're trying to you know, get some good passes, get that front row attack a little bit better.
Backup setter here. It'd be interesting to see if he takes the hands position for this point.
Ooh.
But we're not going to get a chance to see it. What a bomb unleashed out of the middle.
Great play by Peter Christian. Even better set by John Mark.
John Mark's really come into his own this year. When you look at player of the All-Star game, Josh Lynch last year as a setter being out for injury, he's come up huge. And the Saints just can't get set point. 24-22, Saints still leading it. As we have Jeremy Hoekstra entering the game for the Lords, taking out Braden Rogers. Down two with the ball. Jansen for the Lords. Good float serve handled by the Saints. Libero setting out of the back court. Rankin with the dig. Jean-Marc goes to Hernandez. And another block from the Lords. They're right back in it, 24-23. Saints forced to call a timeout. Coach Rob Lynch. 24-23 after being up and controlling most of the set. As Coach Lynch burns his timeout, what's he thinking? What's his message?
You know, they were up 18-13, I think, earlier in the set, so it really started to turn at that point. And what happened was the passing broke down. So you've noticed in the last few points, St. Clair, the free ball passing hasn't been great. Digs have just been really far off the net, and even the serve receive haven't been on point. All they need is one good pass here, and they've got lots of offensive weapons to finish this set.
And conversely, Durham has fought back quite nicely here, and they're right in this. They've weathered the storm of the home crowd. This is going to be a great finish to the first set. This is just going to be a great match here. Marquee matchup, Friday night, opening night of the OCAA tournament.
Yeah, Durham has gotten comfortable with the crowd noise, and you know, I think a lot of them are embracing the moment and then just enjoying it. I remember as a player, anytime you had a crowd like this, I don't know, it's just way more fun to play.
Eric Jansen serving, pressure serve gets it in. Connor West, kept alive by Rankin. Hernandez, off the block again, kept alive. Huge swing out of the middle, sent back over by the Lords. And Hernandez finishes off in style. Point set, Saints.
Really scrappy play from St. Clair. A couple of tough digs just to keep that point alive before finally getting it to the OCAA Player of the Year for the final kill.
Yeah, there's just a lot of weapons on this St. Clair team. Coach Lynch puts people in places where they can be successful. First set here, 25-23. St. Clair takes it home. And we've got Dominic Papa here courtside with an interview.
Courtside, we have it all going on here tonight at the St. Clair College Sportsplex. The Saints managed to hold on to set number one, 25-23. Coach Chris Brekka, that was a tough match. I mean, great for the Saints, but boy, they had a hard time putting Durham away in that first one.
Well, I think at first Durham was sitting back a little bit, and they weren't being aggressive, and then they found the deep court on the Saints side, and they were scoring back there. Our boys got to rally around that and keep those balls up.
How much of this crowd here, Chris, do you think is playing into the favor of the Saints, and maybe even they're feeding off of it?
Oh, absolutely. The energy in here is incredible. They've got some crazy signs out there, so the boys know they got the support, and I think that they're bringing that out in their game.
Anything you saw in that first game that, if you're Coach Lynch, that maybe does concern you about your team?
Well, I think John Mark's got to keep running his middle. He's got to keep running stuff out there. When the boys have one blocker on them, they just, you know, I mean, they're going to score on it. Durham's not incredibly good at digging those balls. If we can keep running and keeping them guessing,
awesome. We
got one blocker, they're scoring.
Anything from Durham that maybe caught you off guard? I mean, you have to be impressed with the resiliency there that they showed towards the end of that first set. They just didn't walk away. They could have folded it up early, and they fought themselves back into the contest.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. They made a couple really key digs, and they made a couple really key points in the back row for us. I think that that kept them alive, and yeah, they showed that they didn't want to.
Now, how much, from a coaching standpoint, do you go game by game, especially in a tournament like this, Chris, or is it just status quo? Let's keep doing what we're doing. Is it not simply game by game?
Well, you know what? I think you got to keep going with what's working, of course, but you do have to run some things and try and get them to step out of the box a little bit, step up their game.
All right. Well, we'll see if that continues. We'll check back in with you a little bit later on. The coach, Chris Brekka, giving us her thoughts after that first set. The Saints win it 25-23. We're going to send it back over to the play-by-play team, Shane Burney and Steve Gomes, as they get set to call set number two. You're watching OCAA Volleyball on WE TV.
Welcome back to the St. Clair Athletic Center. As you see, the before the band, before the cheerleaders, and a ton of fans in the stands, we're witness to some phenomenal volleyball. First set, 25-23, the victors were the Saints.
Yeah, this drum team is, you know, keeping the excitement alive between sets. Loving this atmosphere. In that first set, pretty balanced offense on both ends. Jay Hernandez got started with four kills. Peter Christian really played well, four kills on four attacks, so really efficient work out of him. We'll see how this progresses, but really a balanced attack from both sides.
Yeah, the big thing for the Saints is Hernandez got in trouble with about four hitting errors, so he's been a wash. Nice to see him get going in a positive manner, just build off those kills and maybe flush out some of those nerves. He definitely has the ability to take over this game.
Yeah, and Durham has really started serving Manic, as they have here.
Manic puts in a dime, and it's wasted into the net. Point for the Lords.
All right, jinx Peter Christian.
He was hitting 1,000.
Yeah.
Just like that, down to 800. Serve off the tape. Manic passes a dime out to Hernandez. There he is. Just swings hard, doesn't care who's there.
It was important to see two good passes from Manic to start the set. He had a couple questionable passes in the end of the last set, so he's kind of settled down. Played really well at the start of the previous set, though, as well.
Manic with the serve again long. It's two service errors for him today. Too many in a game like tonight, especially a float server. You want to see a float server serving aggressive, but it's got to be in. Serving for the Lords, Mike Harper, 6'4", out of Oakville, Ontario. Third year of eligibility. Jean-Marc goes back to the middle and touch at the net. Point, Saints.
Yeah, good cut to one from Peter Christian there. He saw the block taking away one half of the court, so he went and swung back to the other half.
Now with the serve is Christian. Can't be handled easily by the Lords. Roll shot. Hernandez off the block, kept alive. Connor West with the dig. Backcourt from Manic. Lords pump it outside. Jansen can't get it done. Hernandez rolls it, kept alive. Lords follow with a tip, and we're gonna have a center line violation. It's just a tough call going against the Saints.
Looking at the size of Travis's feet, I have a hard time believing a whole foot got over that line. But
yeah, that's just a call you might want to hold your whistle on.
Yeah.
Rankin, LePain, just out of bounds. We see another hitting error by Hernandez.
It seems early on when Jay has missed, it's been on that line shot. So maybe it's a strategic move by Durham, given that, leaving that open for him.
Manic. West outside, off the net. No touch point, Lords, as they're up early, 5-2. Sense a little bit of nerves coming through now for the Saints. They continue to serve Manic. Up the middle, and that had absolutely no chance. The set went right into the block. forcing coach Rob Lynch of the Saints to burn his first time out. You're watching OCAA Volleyball here on WeTV. We'll be back in a few.
Hi, I'm Ed Jovanovsky. Watch us on WeTV. We got you covered.
And we're back here at the St. Clair College Athletic Center. What a beautiful facility. Lots of people on hand to witness this great game between the Saints and the Durham Lords. Saints took the first set close, 25-23. And now are trailing 6-2 to the Lords in this second set with the ball serving Peter Keepers.
It seems like after that first set win, you know, when you win those emotional victories, there's a bit of a letdown occasionally.
Off the block and out of bounds. That's a point for the Saints.
Good to see him getting back on track. There, you know, he saw the big double block, didn't try to hit a crazy line shot, instead, you know, hit hard and hit high.
That's the experience of Coach Lynch coming out of the timeout, get your big gun back on track. And there it is out of the middle. Waggle getting it done, sealing off the net. The now, best sets come from the other side.
Jay has this odd serve where occasionally he'll hit a float serve, but as hard as he can. So I think like he hopes to hit the other team off guard, and sometimes it works for him.
Off the block, out of bounds. Point for the Lords. Serving here, Eric Jansen. Tough float serve handled by Connor West. Right side for Hernandez. He's a little late getting there, but still gets it done. Point, Saints.
Oh, there's some interesting people in the crowd today going wild, enjoying the moment.
Connor West sizes up the opponent, puts in the serve. Running the middle, Durham. Rankin to Hernandez, finds the line. That's a tough angle.
That's three kills in a row for Jay Hernandez. He's getting warmed up. And one thing you may not have noticed there, John Mark passed that ball behind the attack line to allow his libero, Josh Rankin, to set the right side player.
That's something that's kind of come to be a new play in the last few years. You used to have middles kind of taking the second ball in that situation. Not always the best result.
Yeah, for some reason, they didn't trust the middle's ball control. I'm still trying to figure that one out.
Huge block by Jean-Marc LePay as he stared through the net. It just reminded the left side hitter you got blocked by a setter.
Yeah. Big block. Big block.
Jean-Marc, not your average setter. We got two tall athletic setters playing in today's game between LePay and Gibson. Connor West lines it up. Short serve. One option for Durham to go outside. Dug up by Rankin. West pushes the free ball. Gibson goes back court, and that's a big kill from Eric Jansen. In rhythm. Silences the crowd for a moment. Nick Coleman serving for the Lords. Taking his time, floating it up. LePain pushes out to Manic, and it lands off the block and in. That should have been played up by the Saints.
Yeah, Jean-Marc made a late decision to let it drop, and you could see he was instantly regretting it.
Two-point game, second set. Saints lead it 1-0 in the match, trail 9-7 here in the set. Connor West passes a dime. They go back to Hernandez. One of the rare digs from Durham. Manick off the block. Point for the Lords.
Durham is doing a good job putting a lot of pressure on St. Clair on their serve receive.
Coleman dialing up the serve. Tough serve goes long. Those hard, flat serves sometimes sail on you. Travis Weigel with the ball for the Saints. Backcourt attack from the Lords. Handled by Waggle. Well, sort of. Free ball from Connor West. Looks like we're getting a lift called. Paul Higgins blows the whistle. Matthew Gibson, the setter. Oh my heavens.
You can't serve a ball any shorter than that.
It didn't even, I think that ball might have came down on the center line after it hit the tape.
Yeah, nearly impossible to replicate.
Connor West with the dime. Manick unloads off the antenna. Point Lords. It's coming apart quickly here for the Saints as they trail 13-8. And Coach Lynch goes to his bench, bringing in Curtis Locke for Manick.
Now, Curtis Locke is a bit more of an experienced player, a little less explosive, but a smart player and is used to playing in this type of situation.
They go to him right off the bench. And it ends up in a point for St. Clair. Curtis Locke has really been hampered by a knee injury for the good portion of his career. Still playing through it.
Yeah, he started his career at the University of Windsor before coming here to finish it off.
I believe he was a former teammate of yours for a year. Did he catch you for a year? Or?
Yeah, for 1 year. 1 year I played with Curtis.
Until you moved on to bigger and better things. Off the block, out of bounds. That's a point for the Lords as they're up 14-9. It's a tough serve receive. For the Saints, you got Hernandez outside in an unnatural position. You got Locke out of the right side where he's not used to being. So they go outside to Hernandez, and he gets a job done off the defense out of bounds.
And Curtis is more of an offensive player than a defensive player, so I would expect Durham to test his serve receive and see what he's made of today.
That's what it's going to come down to if the Saints can handle the Lord's serve. Curtis Locke jumps up the spinner and it finds the middle of the net. Kind of sense a little bit of air letting out of this stadium here.
Yeah, they've fallen behind five in this second set. They're going to have to regain the momentum somehow. They've really relied on Jay for a good portion of the set, but they're going to need, you know, Connor's going to have to play a bigger role, I think, in the offense. And it's really going to come down to passing.
And there you saw a suspect pass from the Saints causing LePain to touch it twice. Point Lords up 16-10. LePain right side to Hernandez, single block, and he's able to go cross court with some authority. That's what we're used to seeing.
Yeah, he really has success with the cross-court shot. It doesn't matter if there's a single or a double block there. He's able to hit a nice sharp angle and effectively hit it.
Christian with the serve. Right side attack from the Lords goes way long. Not even close from Petrus Keepers.
And Petrus, in a lot of his swings, so far today, they've all been long. He doesn't have that natural snap, natural spin on the ball to keep it in the court.
Outside from the Lords, that's number 12, Eric Jansen. When he's in rhythm and looks comfortable, he can unleash on a ball. We've got a sub for the Lords. Entering the game is number 3, Ben Gledhill. He's a backup setter. We'll see where he takes position. Maybe he might be taking hands for the play here. Definitely in just to serve the ball in the court. Free ball offered up by the Saints. Dump point from Gibson. That hurts. As a front row left side blocker, you've got one job, and that is don't let the setter dump.
And as a setter, any ball that's drifting over to the middle of the court, you know that you're probably going to catch him off guard. That's usually a little bit better opportunity for you to dump.
As Hernandez finally gets the line shot going, taking care of the Lords libero in the process. Hernandez, after the kill, serving. Trailing by 5. Lords go up the middle. Hernandez gets the dig. Kept alive by the Saints. And 2 hits being called on the setter.
This defense is anchored by Connor West and Josh Rankin. They're all over the place.
Josh Rankin was among the top leaders in digs per game for the year. Definitely the cornerstone for the Saints defense and serve receive. Hernandez keeps the pressure on with a hard float serve. Forces the Lords outside off the block and down.
Tough break for St. Clair. They had a nicely formed triple block and just found a hole through.
It's one of the things that Coach Lynch preaches. When you can, get 3. 3 blocks makes it awfully difficult on your outside hitters. Connor West off the block and down. That's a smart veteran swing there.
One thing I'm kind of worried about for St. Clair, you notice all of these passes are getting to John Mark right around the attack line. It's really taking the middle attack out of the game right now. They really need to get those passes tighter to the net.
Ball gets pushed outside.
There's a great pass.
That was the one. LePain needs to score that ball. We've got some more players changing for the Lords. Exiting the game is number 10, Nick Coleman. He's being replaced by Luke Kilborn. 6'5", left side out of Ingersoll in his 5th year. He comes up with a float serve. Right at Curtis Locke. Couldn't handle it. Somehow, some way, the Saints get the point.
And this is where they really miss Dave Binder. He had been a consistent passer as well as, a very dominant offensive player. So between Curtis and Manic, I can see, a substitution going back and forth with those two. Whoever passes better is going to be the one who stays on the court.
Right side, and you see Matthew Gibson was the setter, now becomes a hitter as Ben Gledhill has entered the game. Now he's leaving as Gibson goes into the backcourt. Gledhill just can't stay in the game. He's too undersized to be in the front court. He's only 5'8". We understand that's an average-sized man, but not in the game of volleyball. Service error.
Unfortunately, everyone has to play on that almost 8-foot net.
Jean-Marc LePain rifles a serve out of bounds. The scary thing about that 8-foot net is that's almost the world record for high jump.
That guy should play volleyball.
15, Jeremy Hoekstra serving for the Lords. Just over the high jump bar. Off the block, still down. Curtis Locke out of the right side.
He's fired up. He's got a nice playoff beard developed, so you can tell he's been waiting for the moment.
Let's see if he goes back to the jump serve after the last one found the bottom of the net. And rightfully so, goes to the float. Outside for the Lords. Huge dig by Rankin. and they go to lock out of the backcourt, and it finds the bottom of the tape.
That's one area where Manic has had some success. He's a little more explosive, so those back row attacks sometimes rely on a lot of athleticism.
Mike Harper serving for the Lords. LePang goes back to Hernandez, and he puts it into the net. Not looking good on the side of the Saints. 24-18, Lords on top, looking to knot it up.
You can see Josh Rankin pleading with his teammates, you know, trying to rally them here. It seems like they've kind of given up in this second set. We'll see what happens.
Hernandez unleashes the boom. Substitution for the Saints. We've got a server entering the game. That is Keaton Rebkowek. Lines it up, gives her a toss, and runs the attack into the middle of the net. 25-19 is the final of set number two here on Friday night, 8 p.m. game. Our marquee matchup, knotted up at one set apiece.
So for St. Clair, I think the biggest issue and the biggest question they need to answer is, what are you going to do without Dave Binder? Because you can see that, you know, the regular starters are kind of doing their thing, and it's really going to come down to who plays between Manic and Curtis Locke.
Very true. We have Dominic Papa courtside with Dave Austin.
Certainly no shortage of excitement with this contest as the Durham Lords come back to tie it at one set each. Our analyst Dave Austin, of course, joining us. Dave, what was different in that second game than what you saw in the first one?
Well, the worrisome trend started about halfway through the first game, Dom. St. Clair's just not passing the ball as well as they need to. And Coach Lynch will tell you, it starts with the little things. In this game, you've got to pass the ball well, and the setter, Jean-Marc, he's not getting enough options off the passes. He's basically got one choice because of where the passes are going. So, and Durham, give them credit, they've come back. They're a proud team, proud pedigree, and they've been reading where the hits are going to come from, and they've done a good job of putting themselves right back in this match.
How much of this, of course, the adrenaline level was huge for the Saints in that first game, feeding off the crowd, but in a way, could that have hurt them in that second game to try to maintain it or sustain that level of intensity?
I'm glad you mentioned the crowd. What a great atmosphere here tonight. It's a great atmosphere, but yeah, it's hard to sustain that. You get that immediate rush coming out of the gate, and they've just been a little bit flat ever since. Let's see. This is a very, very important game coming up right now.
It's coming up big for Durham. That really has helped them get over the hump here and really silenced the crowd a little bit here.
Well, I thought their setter is to spread the ball around beautifully. And if you watch him on the court, he's the calming influence for the rest of the team. Number 10. Great, playing a great match.
Take us into the St. Clair huddle there, Coach Austin. What's Coach Lynch telling the guys?
I've coached with Coach Lynch. I know exactly what he's saying right now. He wants them to do the little things right. He's going to emphasize that. If we do the little things right, everything else will fall into place.
All right, well, we'll see if they can turn it around. We'll check in with you after the game, okay?
Thanks very much, Austin.
Coach Dave Austin helping us out here. Again, tied one set each between the Durham Lords and the St. Clair College Saints. We're going to go back over our play-by-play team, Shane Burney and Steve Gomes, for the call of set number three.
What an atmosphere here at St. Clair Athletic Center. We've got the band rocking, we've got the cheerleaders pumping everybody up, and we've got capacity crowd. What an awesome experience here for the OCAA host, St. Clair Saints.
Now, we knew this wasn't going to be an easy match for St. Clair going against an 18-0 team, and Durham's really stepped up in that second set. You know, third set, it can tell a lot of what's going on. So how is St. Clair going to, you know, play their chess pieces? You know, it's kind of a chess match. Who's going to do what on each side of the net?
Yeah, because we're looking at the winner of this game is going to have to play Humber on Saturday night here at 8 o'clock, and You know the Saints want to be in that one. The other premier matchup of the weekend is the Saturday night 8 p.m. game. And then again, obviously, the finals. So we're looking at, a really important second set here.
Yeah, and whoever wins this game is going to play a Humber team that is playing really well. We saw them early today, and a clean sweep against Sheridan. They really played well.
Yeah, and they had this guy that was pretty good, too, if you remember what his name is.
That Terrell guy? I think he's played a little volleyball before.
Yes, indeed. Oh. As we get a kill from Christensen, I think somebody on the Lord's side almost played as a step. What was that, 15? Jeremy Hoekstra almost got stepped on in his face going after a volleyball. Manic back in the game for the Saints, comes up with the serve. And some dirty, stinky, smelly hands from Luke Fafard on the side of the Durham.
So looking at the stats after our first two sets, for Durham, it's really not one player that's dominating offensively. They got four kills from Nick Coleman. And it's three kills here, two kills there. It's a little bit of everything. On the St. Clair side, Jason Hernandez already has racked up 12 kills. Peter Christian has five. A little more offense on the St. Clair side, but I guess Durham has served better and playing a little bit more defense.
And the Saints have made a lot of errors. There was not an error there as Connor West unloads. Saints have made a lot of serving errors and hitting errors that just are unlike the St. Clair team that we've seen all season long.
And that's Connor's fifth kill. He's hitting a good clip here. He's 5 for 11.
And there's your tall setter being an athlete at the net, fixing bad passes. Yeah, point for the Lords.
Connor's got to be up there, but he's going to need a little help from Travis Waggle there to take that away.
Not often that you see a setter go over top of a left side block with a dump. There's a service error from the Lords. Hernandez back to take a swing. Lords run the middle, kept up by Connor West. The Lords want a lift and they're not getting it. LePain's got to play the first ball. Goes out to West, and I think he hit a home run there. That went into the stands.
Oh. Yeah, unfortunate after that dig. A nice broken play set from Josh Rankin. Gave him some options, but just a poor contact on the ball.
Nick Coleman with the ball. Knotted up at 4 apiece here and also tied one set aside. And he puts it into the net. Not happy with himself as the Saints rejoice.
Yeah, that's a couple missed serves from him already off a standing float serve. It really needs to be in. It's not too aggressive.
Connor West lines it up. Right into the net, trading service errors. So unlike this Saints team.
And Connor usually has a really good touch on his float serve. He's able to hit different parts of the court, just not happening there.
Rankin, LePain. Christian can't get it done in the middle. Lords go back to the right side. Hernandez keeps the ball in play. Backcourt attack off the block and down. That's Eric Jansen. You really see Matthew Gibson just spreading the ball around so nicely for these Durham Lords.
Yeah, he's done a really good job offensively as well as spreading the ball around. He's kind of been key to this game so far.
Manic delivers a great pass. Might as well reward him with a set. And he unleashes on a left side ball.
He's got a lot of talent. I'd like to see how his career ends up with St. Clair, but right now, kind of a raw talent, but you can tell there's a lot there.
Weigel's serve handled easily by the Lords, and that ball goes off Manic's head. And we have a lift called on the Saints. Would have been great to see that ball stay alive.
Yeah. I haven't seen a ball hit the roof in this stadium, and that one was as close as you can get. Still nothing.
What a phenomenal building this is, with a roof that just goes up and up and up. Jean-Marc turns and swings on a ball. A little ill-advised effort there. Misses way wide. Lords on top, 8-6 here in the second set.
If there's one thing I would be critical of Jean-Marc's game, is just his decision-making on when to dump. You know, there's good times to do it, and I feel like hasn't chosen the right time so far.
Well, he knew when to set the middle, and that was there. Jean-Marc Le Pen serving. The lefty out of Maidstone, Ontario, graduate of Essex High School. Lords counter outside. Oh my. How does that hit the floor? Finds a gaping hole.
Yeah, breakdown on defense. I'm not sure what happened there. It looks like Josh Rankin is playing in six back. Maybe he misread the swing.
Coach Lynch was not looking too impressed about that. Rankin passes the dime. Manic unloads. Oh, baby.
Manic has really taken that benching earlier in the match, you know, and done a lot with it. He's come out with a lot of fire, a lot of energy.
Manic to serve. Gibson up the middle, off the block, and in. Gibson
and for
again,
St. Clair
using
again,
all.
You know, a ball dropping in six back where there should be a defender. They're kind of creeping in a little too much. A little too much anticipation and not sticking to the system.
Keepers with the serve. Goes way long. He tried the corner and missed. Saints serving 18, Peter Christian. Outside with the Lords, and he finds the line. Eric Jansen.
Yeah, another good set for Matthew Gibson. He's really taking over this game, spreading the ball around.
Lords attack Connor West with the serve. Hernandez absolutely unleashes on a ball and answers.
When St. Clair gets one good pass to start it off, if you give him a single block, he's just going to unload on the ball.
Little bit of talent there from the second all-time leading scorer. Le Pen seals the net. Rankin with a dig. Manic, roll shot handled by the Lords. Back court, and that is number 12, Eric Jansen. Big swing. Lords on top by two. Waiting on a volleyball. Coleman's got it. Ready to serve. Serve goes long. Point. Saints.
Another service error from number 10, Nick Coleman. I wouldn't be surprised if they start using a serving sub for him. That's three, and you can see the look on his face. He's lost confidence in his serve.
Connor West serving. Looks like it's going to be tight. And Gibson goes off the block and down. He's begging for a timeout, Gibson, from his coach. And he is just fuming at his teammates. 12-12 all knotted up here in the third set. You're watching OCAA Volleyball here on WeTV.
Manpower, that's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the billion-dollar parkway. That's real manpower in action. End-to-end over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. our manpower is in demand. Well-trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LiUNA. Feel the power.
Hi, I'm Ed Jovanovski. Watch us on WeTV. We got you covered.
And we're back here in the third set, OCAA volleyball playoff action here between the Saints and the Lords. All knotted up at 12. We just coming out of the timeout, noticing a little dissension in the ranks on the Durham Lords timeout. A little bit of arguing, maybe they were out of rotation or something. Wasn't pretty in the timeout.
Matthew Gibson was pleading for a timeout even before that last point, so he must have seen something in the rotation or something that he really didn't like.
Connor West with the ball for the Saints. 12-12, one set apiece. Gibson goes back court. They've had a lot of success out of the back middle. And there is Mr. Kill out of the right side. Hernandez.
Yeah, it's really becoming a Jay Hernandez versus Eric Jansen offensive showdown.
I know who I'd put my money on. Jansen's a formidable opponent, but if they're going head-to-head, I'm taking the second all-time scorer in league history. Matthew Gibson back to serve.
If Durham is going to take this set, they're going to need more out of Petrus.
There's an overpass from the Saints. Manic just couldn't handle the serve. Sealed up on the net. Point Lords. They're up 14-13. Gibson. Tough serve. Could not be handled by Manic. We'll see how long Coach Lynch goes with his inexperienced left side. Seems to be struggling passing today.
It's good to see we've got the entire University of Windsor men's volleyball team in attendance today in the stands. They just came points away from going to the national tournament.
And here we are, the Saints looking to punch their ticket. Got to get by Durham tonight as they trail 16-13. Well, now 16-14 as Gibson delivers a service error. Always nice to see a strong volleyball community within the city of Windsor showing up to support any kind of local volleyball. As we now have some debris blowing out on the court there, Mark Eckert, the line judge, comes in to save the day. Weigel with the serve. Right side, and there's a stuff block from Manic. Oh, baby.
Big solo block.
That's a six-footer. 6 feet small stuff block.
Don't tell his vertical that.
Oh, baby. And there's a terrible pass.
Yeah.
Two contacts or a lift now called on the Lords.
They're picking on Jeremy Hoekstra right now. Keep that serve, Adam.
Here comes the sub. I bet you it's for Hoekstra. As there's a little dissension, again, we see Matthew Gibson arguing with Coach Matt Sasaki about a substitution. Just doesn't look like the leader of the Lords is in tune with his coach. Gibson gets called for a lift.
And every time that Gibson has, you know, yelled at his coach from the court or, you know, made some type of comment, he's followed it up with an error. So, you know, he's really kind of keep his mouth shut. And
that's a terrible service error. Not what you want to see.
St. Clair has gained momentum here because a lot of Durham mistakes. So, very similar to the last set, how St. Clair was making some errors to end the second set. It seems like Durham is losing a bit of momentum.
And that ball lands just long. Point for the Saints as the crowd's getting back into it here.
A lot of service errors from both sides.
LePain tosses, rolls it in. Left side attack from the Lords. Long. That's Eric Jansen. Just a bit outside. LePain. Good pass by the Lords. Again outside to Jansen. Huge block by the Saints. That's a roof, if I've ever seen one. Timeout called by Coach Matsusaki. Let's see if he can regain the strength of his opponent, or the strength of his teammates there. And you are watching OCAA Volleyball here on WE TV as we pause to pay some bills. St. Clair Sportsplex, as we are all knotted up, one set apiece, and the Saints are leading in the third set, 20-17. Coach Lynch is looking to punch his ticket into the next round with his St. Clair Saints as they host the OCAA Playdown Tournament here. As we get ready to regain our action.
Be interesting to see how who Matthew Gibson sets here. He's kind of gone to Jansen a little too often. We'll see if he goes back to him again or tries to mix it up.
LePain off the tape. Ball's got to go back out to Jansen, and it's sealed off at the net. Manick seals the net again for the Saints. Backcourt to Connor West, and a dig made in the backcourt by Durham. And a roll shot from the middle. The Saints taking care of business any way they can. Crafty veteran.
Peter Christian was even surprised by his own play there. You could see the smile on his face immediately after getting the kill.
That's some fifth year senior experience right there. LePain into the net after a momentum play like that. Oh man.
Good service run from him though. I think they got three or four serves in that rotation.
Entering the game, Luke Kilborn. He's coming in with one purpose, and that's to put the serve in. Let's see if he can get it done. Connor West handles the serve, pumps it out to Hernandez. Gibson goes to the middle, swallowed up by the Saints defense. Manick out of bounds. 21-19, Saints still on top. Serving, Kilborn. Aggressive float serve, eats up West. Hernandez. Outside, the Lords cannot get her connected.
And that all came from Jay Hernandez putting an aggressive ball on the other side of the court. They really had a broken play, not much they could do. He put a tough swing on the other side, which led to the mistake.
Manick with the serve, plus three. Gibson up the middle, and there's a stop block, Peter Christian.
Big block.
Just listen to that crowd.
Huge block. Nicely done by Peter
Christian.
What
an atmosphere here at St. Clair College. Gibson to the right side. Stuffed again at the net. And it won't make it over. That's keepers. Stuff blocked.
This blocking lineup for St. Clair is really doing a number on them.
Got a small front row too, looking at West, Hernandez, and Christian. Christian, the tallest at 6'4", has an undersized middle. Outside, that was handled by the Saints defense, but not able to send back over.
St. Clair now 1 point away from taking the set.
Keepers is out, and Gledhill is in. The last time we saw this substitution, Gledhill became the setter and unleashed Matthew Gibson, scoring a couple of points late in the set. We'll see if they go back to it. LePang goes out to West, and what do we have here but a double contact called. LePang knew it. 24-21, Saints still looking to run away with this third set. Gledhill. Hernandez off the block and out of bounds. Point set for your St. Clair Saints as they go up 2-1 here on WeTV OCAA Volleyball here at the St. Clair College Sportsplex. Take a look at the fans. What an atmosphere here on a Friday night marquee matchup game.
So we got this pivotal, well, the pivotal third set just finished, and now it'll be interesting to see if Durham can answer just like they did after the first set.
And we're gonna throw it over to Dominic Papa, who has an interview courtside.
Well, I finally found someone about my height down here at courtside. It's so nice to be talking to somebody eye to eye here. It's the new president of St. Clair College, Mrs. Patty France. Congratulations on
Thank you.
Thank
you so much. Thank you.
Certainly, I would imagine the last 24 hours for you has just been a whirlwind.
Yes, absolutely. I think I'm going to sleep like a baby tonight. Yes. So, right. Thank you.
All right. Well, you come in tonight. You're a fan tonight. You're not working as
no,
a president.
No, not working. It was a great evening. As you can see, the excitement. Students are thrilled. Sports at St. Clair College is a huge element of student life, and I think tonight speaks for itself, and the students are having a blast. So, and we won! We won! So.
Well, still a tough one. We still got to win one more. But yeah. Tell me, how did Doc... You worked a lot with Dr. Strasser, obviously, over the years. How has he helped you prepare for this next step and, you know, just got you feeling comfortable with taking on this role?
Dr. Strasser has been... I've worked with him for almost 15 years. He's been... a great friend, a good mentor, a strong leader. He was perfect for St. Clair College for the last 15 years. He helped us set up facilities from a community's perspective. He built our reputation. We have positioned ourselves that we certainly have the capacity for future enrollment. And I think it's time now that we focus on academic quality and the student success and what takes place in the classroom.
Of course, he was a pretty big sports fan. Did he implement some of that into you?
He did. He certainly got me to come out to the games, and the students get so excited. And like I said earlier, sports is a huge part of student life, and it's just part of what we do here at St. Clair College. And our new facility here, we certainly hope that we can grow our athletic opportunities for our students, and the students love the facilities. When they come here and take tours, they fall in love with the center and they say, I'm coming, I'm sold. So,
congratulations again on everything. Good luck with it. Thanks for doing this with us tonight. And we'll definitely look forward to seeing you at many of the events here.
Okay, thank you so much. It was nice to see you.
All
thank
right.
you.
Patty France, the new president here at St. Clair College. Let's get back over to the play-by-play guys, Shane Burney and Steve Gomes.
New president's taken over quite the athletic facility and quite the atmosphere here tonight in her college. As the St. Clair Saints are up 2-1 in front of their home crowd in OCAA playoff volleyball action. Lords with the serve. Hoekstra puts it into the net. Point for the Saints.
And after our first three sets, I'll give you some statistical knowledge, I guess. Jay Hernandez is leading all players with 15 kills already. Peter Christian is second with 8. Connor West has 5 and Manic has 4. On the Durham side, Matthew Gibson as a setter has four, Nick Coleman has six, and Eric Jansen has six. But Eric, for 24 sets, is six enough kills?
A little subpar, considering he probably has that many errors as well. Off the block.
And there's another.
Oh, no, it was not off the block. It hit the tape. Another error.
Yeah.
You look at Jansen, he should be their leader, and he's probably blanking with the same amount of kills and errors, if not more errors than kills. Not going to get the job done against the St. Clair team. Gibson tries to get cute at the net, setting a one-handed back quick, no dice. And we've already got a quick timeout from Coach George Matsusaki for the Durham Lords as they trail 4-0. And again, we're just going to pause for a brief moment to pay some bills, and you're watching WE TV OCAA Volleyball.
Hi, I'm Joel Quenneville, coach of the Chicago Blackhawks, and a proud graduate of FJ Brennan High. I can remember fondly my five great years at Brennan. It seems like just yesterday that we're there. A lot of great life lessons that I learned along the way, particularly from my teachers in the Catholic program. Want to wish everybody there good luck, and look forward to being a proud graduate and being a proud Cardinal going on here in, here in Chicago.
And we're back at the St. Clair Sportsplex. Saints up 4-0, looking to run away with this set here and win 3-1. Durham's got some other ideas. They want to get back in this match to survive and keep in this playoff.
Yeah, it's a really pivotal point in the match. Down 4-0, they lose this set, their year is done. So they really need to rebound and get something going. For St. Clair, just continue doing what you're doing. Durham is causing a lot of mistakes for themselves.
Manick out of the timeout with a serve. Durham scores on an ugly attack off the block, out of bounds.
And no one thing I want to monitor the rest of the set is, you know, the play of Matthew Gibson. He's played really well for them so far in this set, but you can tell that his temper might be getting the better of him at times. So it's good to play with emotion, but if it's detrimental to your play, I don't know, they can't afford that right now.
Hard swing from Hernandez.
Just a really smart play. You know, he knew being so far off the net that he had to go for the deepest corner of the court if he's going to have any chance, but swung hard, swung with some good snap on the ball. Good attack.
Durham cannot handle the serve from the Saints. Point St. Clair, 6-1. Serving Peter Christian, 6-4 out of Chatham. Fifth-year senior.
Durham is facing, you know, possibly their first loss of the season right now. It'll be interesting to see how they deal with the adversity. They rebounded well in the second set, but, you know, the match wasn't on the line. Let's see how they deal with it here.
Manick, Lepin, West, just out of bounds. Point Lords. Unusual of Connor to miss that shot.
Yeah, Manick passed a nice high ball so that John Mark could get underneath, but it's just got to get tighter to the net.
Keeper's serve way out of bounds. Hernandez with the ball for the Saints now.
Just too many service errors for Durham.
Hernandez. Dug up by the Saints defense. Rankin did it and answered by the Lords defense. That was Luke Fafard. West takes them off. Looks like he's playing on the sand courts. Beauty roll.
When executed properly, those roll shots look so pretty. If you can get it just over the blocker's hands, just a nice roll shot.
Hernandez serving short to position two. Stuffed at the net of the Lords. Outside. Ball dug up by Josh Rankin. Connor West tries to wipe the block, can't get it out of bounds though. Point, Durham.
Josh Rankin is all over the place. He's playing a really, really good defensive game, digging balls that really you don't think anyone's gonna get to.
He's not afraid to put it all on the line for a dig. Connor West, touched out of bounds. No, thought there was a touch. Guess not.
Connor has very good ball control and you know, has a lot of shots, but he's had a few balls get away from him today.
There's a great pass from Manic, able to run the middle, and that is vintage Saints. Good passing leads to a nice strong attack out of the middle.
Manic has really stepped up since being re-entered into the game. Passing's been pretty good offensively. He can do a lot of things with his athleticism.
Lawrence can't handle it. They go back to the right side, and oh my heavens, keepers can't get a serve in, can't get an attack in. Tough day.
Yeah, I don't like that choice. Petrus hasn't hit a C-ball, a back row attack in the court, it seems, the whole game. They've all been way long.
Saints capitalizing on the errors from the Lords, and you know what? The Saints just gave an error away themselves. Serve goes long.
That's two now for Connor. Let's see if Nick Coleman can put this one in. He's missed three or four serves already today.
Oh. Manic just can't get the job done. Serve goes off Manic's attempted pass and out of bounds.
Probably a big sigh of relief for Nick Coleman after missing all those serves to get an ace. Really boost your confidence.
Coleman still with the ball. Manic passes a good one. Hernandez finds the back line. He's painting that thing all night.
Durham has to expect Jay Hernandez to get the ball. It seems like he's getting set a ton of balls, but their defense isn't really reacting well to it, especially the block.
Manic gets tooled at the net by Gibson. Gibson always seems to find a way to win those little battles, jousts at the net.
Yeah, it looks like he's settled down as well.
He can be very dangerous when he's calm and ready to go, and there's the answer from Jean-Marc Le Pen.
There's been a few points in the match where one setter dumps and the other setter dumps, and it's kind of interesting having these big setters who are offensive.
That was like our previous match with the step plays going back and forth. Ball finds the court. Point for the Lords. Saints still lead it by three.
Being up three, the Saints just focus in on getting that first pass. Side out every time you have a chance.
You know they're serving at Manic. And a missed opportunity. They went to Rankin. Still finds him the point as Hernandez goes wide with his attack. 12-10, fourth set. Saints up 2-1. 15, Jeremy Hoekstra. Blows it way out of bounds. Mike Rock, linesman, goes up with the flag. Point for the Saints. Manic serving.
Coach Lynch is electing to let his servers choose the location. Usually on most teams, you'll see a coach up with a clipboard given a position for a server to attack. He's allowing them to kind of see which seam they want to hit or what player they want to serve to.
Manic takes a look. Finds his man, and a serve drops it in over the libero's head. Luke Fafard lets it drop. timeout called by the Lords as they trail 15-10 here in the fourth set. You're watching OCAA Volleyball here on WE TV.
Bye.
Great. My car's blocked in.
I got this. I think the parking brake is on. Geez, what's in this thing, rocks?
And welcome back to the St. Clair College Athletic Center, where we are being privy to some great volleyball action here put on by the Saints and the Durham Lords. Saints up 2-1 in the fourth set and also leading 15-10 in front of this capacity crowd here at St. Clair College.
It's been a really interesting match to watch. There's been a lot of momentum swings each way, and you know, key players have, you know, made mistakes and then stepped up, and then, you know, someone else steps up. So it's been really fun to watch.
That combined with the band, the cheerleaders, the crowd, the atmosphere, it's just been a great night of volleyball, and we've still got a lot more to come as Durham puts away the ball. 11-15, and they go to their bench for a serving sub here. Entering the game is number 7, Luke Kilbourne. He's replacing number 9, Mike Harper.
I think it's unfair for a team to go 18-0 in the regular season and then travel to the opponent's home for a playoff game.
Well, as we talked about, the East Division is comparatively not as strong as the West Division. Points Saints there as they run the middle, Peter Christian.
Peter Christian just racking up kills out of the middle. He's having himself a very solid game.
And again, that's the experience of a fifth-year middle. He's done this a long time.
Yeah, this is the year for St. Clair. If they're going to have some success, I think they know they've got a lot of veteran players that aren't going to be here forever. You got to make the most of this.
There's Hernandez getting it done.
He's making the most of his opportunities.
Second time, all time, kill getter. Christian delivers a great serve. Ball gets pumped outside.
Nice Jansen's dig by attack. Connor.
Handled by the Saints. And this time, Hernandez puts it into the net. 4 contacts called against the Saints.
Some of you watching at home might not realize, but that is an incredibly difficult ball to hit. Coming from deep 6, it was passed up for him to hit a back row ball going over his body. Just a tough ball to hit.
Serving Ben Gledhill. Again, he's the backup setter. Look for him to maybe take the setting position here with Gibson in the front court. Not if Waggle has something to say about it. Oh, baby.
Big kill from Travis. Steve, you played some right side in your day. How do you think Jay stacks up with some of the people you've played against?
Oh, he's definitely a special talent. The biggest thing that he has working against him is his size. He's got to make the most out of every jump, out of every swing. He's got to work 100% to get up in the air. But man, oh man, for a guy his size, he's 6'2", undersized right side. What can you say? Second all-time leading scorer. You can't bet against him. Can't bet against him. And he's a homegrown product, too, here. He's out of Harrow, Ontario, just outside of Windsor.
Another crafty play by Connor West. But you don't always have your best game in you, but you can always do the little things to help your team win.
Speaking about Hernandez, though, on right sides, you clearly know that they're the best players on the court, right? Little bit of bias here. Connor West serving up 20-13 as the Saints have just jumped out in front. You can tell they want this W in front of their hometown crowd. Packed house. Roll shot handled by Hernandez. West with a great play to keep it alive.
Oh!
Hernandez wanted that one.
That would have brought the house down.
Oh man, you could just see and feel the energy building in the stadium.
You know, it's hard to believe the way that the game has kind of unfolded, but St. Clair is a big underdog record-wise in this matchup.
18-0 Durham Lords versus 12-6 St. Clair Saints. The Saints getting it done, 21-14. Rolling on their way to a four-set, 3-1 victory.
This raucous crowd is enjoying every minute of this.
Waggle, float serve. And again, you see a little miscommunication. Jean-Marc jump sets and a tip kill out of the middle. Peter Christian.
Great decision there by Jean-Marc. Fakes the dump to get the middle and the left side up. And Peter Christian, all he has to do is put the ball over the net for the kill.
Waggle serve just off the tape. In play. Dug by Connor West. Hernandez, roll shot is handled by the Lords. Play at the net, and Jean-Marc LePay absolutely houses 6'3" middle Jeremy Hoekstra. Oh, baby. The stare down was in full effect.
He's just putting the nail in the coffin with that point.
23-14 Saints, and a kill out of the right side. And again, we see Matthew Gibson taking some swings in the front court when Ben Gledhill is in, as Ben Gledhill checks out.
And just a reminder to the viewers, the winner of this match is going to play Humber, and that's going to be a really good matchup. St. Clair recently played Humber without their best player and took that in three. I'm sure Humber has a lot to say about how that ended up. I can't wait to see that, if that happens. 1 point away.
Oh, I'm just counting it down. We're less than 24 hours away from a phenomenal matchup. Not to take anything away from this game, but it just seems like St. Clair has a higher purpose than the Durham Lords tonight. Let's watch some action here as Connor West sends over a free ball. Gibson goes to the right side. And Keepers puts one away for the Lords. Clinging to some life here as Coach Lynch just decides to use one of his two timeouts at 23-17.
You know, why not? You know, he's got them to spend. Why not take a second, gather your emotions, gather your breath, and get an attack set up. We would also like to thank Pizza King for hooking us up with some meals today. Had some delicious pizza earlier, and we appreciate it.
Hey, give him a call, 519-944-2201. Phenomenal pizza. Sitting here in these timeouts, what's Coach Lynch really saying to get these guys refocused?
You know, I think he's, you know, getting them a chance to get some water, calming them down. I think they realize they're in a big moment right now. So give them a chance to breathe, relax, because you need your passers to focus in. Get that first pass, get all your options, and if you've got all your options, then you give it to Jay.
He's never a bad choice.
Yeah.
Saints ready to win this one. Up. 5-6. Oh my, up 6. I can't do any math. I almost said 5. Serving it up, Gibson. Manic passes the dime. Hernandez. Lords go to the right side, and that's Keepers. Looks like he finally gets in rhythm, gets a good strong swing together.
Yeah, that's probably the best swing we've seen from him all day.
As you hear the Saints crowd, the Let's Go Saints cheer. A lift called against the Saints.
Yeah, usually they'll allow a double hit on a serve receive, but you need to play a ball kind of above the chest if you're going to volley that.
Gibson continues to serve. Off the tape, handled by West. LePan goes to the middle, and that's money in the bank.
Peter Christian, heck of a game. Jay Hernandez probably leading the team in kills today, but the effect that Peter Christian has had on, you know, balancing the offense is
this
huge.
Is match point. LePan goes short for the ace. No dice. Manic hustles to get the dig and fitting that the Saints take it with a right side kill from Hernandez, and they win this one 3-1, 25-19 in the final set. What a match, what a night. St. Clair College, what a classy venue, classy school, classy winners.
Hard fought match for St. Clair.
We need to start the game.
Shaking hands now on the court.
What a night here at the St. Clair College Sportsplex. Packed crowd, everybody in the city out to watch. The Durham Lords put up a good effort, but it just wasn't enough to eclipse St. Clair and the mission that they were on.
Yeah, tough loss for an 18-0 season just to be one and done, but clearly, St. Clair was the better team today.
You look at how St. Clair did it today. You know, they had balanced offense. They had, you know, obviously led by Jay Hernandez, and you have Jean-Marc LePan spreading the ball around. What is it going to take for them to win this whole tournament weekend?
They got to continue playing like this, and they did this without Dave Binder today. So, an even more impressive feat.
All right, well, we're going to send it over to Dominic Papa. Shane, it's been a great pleasure working with you here tonight. And
you
Dom's
as well.
Dom's got some stuff that we'd like to hear on the sideline here, some special guests.
No shortage of excitement here tonight at the St. Clair College Sportsplex. The hometown team does prevail, a tough game against the Durham Lords, but the Saints find a way to come up with a 3-1
yeah.
victory. Wasn't easy though, Coach Brekka. They were some pretty tense moments.
It was. I like to comment on Connor's craftiness. He made some key plays for them. But you know, at this level, it's the team that makes the least amount of mistakes is the one that's going to come over the win.
So that's a Connor. Connor's been a great leader all year for this team. Anything else that you thought was maybe the difference in this game tonight?
Well, I was hoping that they would have their aggressive serving on. But it seemed to be a serving battle of the back end. But I think that, I mean, I was expecting more from Jay, but I'm sure that Durham is going to key on him because he's the big hitter. And I think Connor was using his
craftiness today instead of his big guns.
With a game like this, Chris, I mean, I'm sure Coach Lynch has told the guys, and the guys are aware of it, he's got some veteran guys there. They know there's not going to be any easy ones, but could their eyes have been opened a little wider tonight? Durham put a little scare in these guys, and they had a tough time finishing off these sets.
Yeah, that's what I mean, like the mistakes that they made, I mean, they really got to clean that up if they expect to go right to the end, because those kinds of things will come back and bite you. They're going to hurt the mistakes that they made. But they're a solid group, right? And I'm glad they pulled it off.
And that's a great point you bring up there, Coach Brekka. I mean, you know, we can sit here and say they had a hard time putting things away, but just the same, they toughed it out. They found a way to put this game away, and that shows a lot of character.
Yes, absolutely. They were a little flat that game that they lost, and they rallied a little bit, but not enough to prevail, and they did in the end.
All right, well, we have our player of the game for tonight, so we're going to have the Windsor Essex Catholic District School Board player of the game presented by Dave Austin. Let's go over to Dave.
Thanks very much, Dom. Jay, congratulations on a wonderful match. Great offensive display. How was it playing in this type of atmosphere tonight for you guys?
You can't ask for much more. I mean, they're so loud. It's even hard to hear them sometimes on the court, but they were behind us the whole way. It was great.
Now, you ran into a little bit of a rough patch in the second game as a team. The passing kind of broke down a bit. What did Coach Lynch have to say to you in the huddle after the end of that second game that turned things around?
He told us to stick to our game plan. We had a scouting report. We had a game plan. We got away from that. Our passing went down a little bit. Went back to our game plan. Came out on top.
Now, are you looking forward to playing Humber tomorrow? What do you have to do tomorrow now to take care of Humber?
They're a good team all around. Terrell, he's going to get his kills. We have to limit those. We have to spread the ball around on our side. Okay.
Once again, Jay, congratulations. The whole city of Windsor is really thrilled about this tonight.
Thank you.
Good job. Way to go. Back to you, Dom.
Squad, David, congratulations to Jason Hernandez, the Windsor Essex Catholic Schoolwork Player of the Day here tonight. And then Durham, as you can see, we have another face on our set here. The head coach of the St. Clair College Saints, Rob Lynch. Thanks for doing this with us, Rob. I can see you survived it all.
I did.
But it was a fun game, actually.
It was a real fun game. Real good opponents, and it was hard to keep our guys, you know, focused. They're a real good team.
What did you think of the energy in here?
The energy was unbelievable. Never, ever have you felt this energy as a team. And the crowd was basically our seventh player.
Yeah, good point made there. We talked about it a little bit earlier. Chris broke it down for us. Dave can break down this game. Got some of the, there were some really key elements, but again, the captain really showed up. What a character player for your club.
Yeah, you know what? We go to Jason every time we need that one point, and he just took us and put us on his shoulders and took care of us.
And did you feel like there was any point where it turned for you?
Second game, we were in a little bit of a lull. We had some missed serves, we had some missed hits. And the guy shook it off, and it wasn't even like they had played that second game. He just let it go, went into the third and played strong and went through it. And in the fourth game, just the energy was just there. You could tell they weren't overhitting. The guys hit the ball into play, kept good serves, and that's what happened.
Well, you're going to be able to enjoy this for maybe a minute.
That's
just
it.
One, yeah.
Just 1 minute. Tomorrow, you know who your opponent is, the Humber Hawks.
Yeah,
yeah 8 o'clock game again. Of course, you're familiar with this club, obviously. Quickly, an overview of what that game's going to be like, Rob, and how you have to prepare for it.
Well, it's the number one attack in the OCAA versus number two attack. So it's going to be Jason versus Terrell. That's what's going to happen. So we need to block him, stop him, and give the ball to Jason. I think that's what we need to do.
All right. Well, hopefully that happens. So congratulations on the victory tonight, Rob. And enjoy it for that minute.
Rest up.
That 1 minute. Yes.
Get some rest, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Okay?
Thank you.
All right. The victorious coach, Rob Lynch, and you know what? Tomorrow's gonna be a pretty exciting day here, Chris.
I think so.
Of course, we got four more games for you tomorrow, and we'll have all the action live here again on WE TV. Starts at 1:30. Mohawk will look to bounce back after being upset earlier today. They'll take on Fleming. The second game of the day will be Sheridan battling with Durham. Of course, Durham just defeated by the Saints. That's our 3:30 game. Then we get into the winner's bracket. Niagara and Fanshawe will square off at approximately 6 p.m. And then, as just mentioned, Humber and St. Clair will battle at 8 p.m. So another great day of volleyball coming up.
I think so.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And certainly you'll be here helping us again tomorrow.
I will be.
We appreciate that.
Yeah.
That's the story here tonight at the St. Clair College Sportsplex. Another outstanding day of volleyball here, not only with the Saints, but with all these teams. Just outstanding talents and very exciting. So if you can't make it down to the Sportsplex tomorrow, don't worry. WE TV's got you covered. We'll be back on live at 1:30 with the entire crew here, bringing you all the action. So that's the story. The Saints win it here 3-1. They advance to the winner's bracket, and we'll see how everything goes tomorrow. I'd like to thank Chris Brecka. I'd like to thank Dave Austin, Shane Burney, Steve Gomes. That's our play-by-play broadcast team. Also, our hardworking crew here doing some outstanding work all day long. Their efforts are very much appreciated. Hopefully you enjoyed it, all the work that they put into this. And we'll try to do it all again tomorrow for you. On behalf of everybody here at WE TV, this is Dominic Papa wishing you a great night. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Take care.